Throngs of travelers begin their trip back to Manila as the holidays come to an end. At the Parañaque Integrated Terminal Exchange, some 170,000 passengers are expected this Tuesday, higher from the 119,000 on New Year's Day. Passenger count at the terminal since December 15 is seen to hit more than 2.6 million on Wednesday. PITX management will be on heightened alert until the end of the week. A similar situation is reported in bus terminals in Quezon City. Officials expect the influx of travelers arriving in the capital region to last until this afternoon. Some passengers, meanwhile, complained of difficulty hailing cabs, as some drivers supposedly refused to cater them. Meanwhile, in ports, the Philippine Coast Guard records over 34,000 outbound and 25,000 inbound travelers. The Coast Guard says over 2,000 of its personnel have been deployed in ports across the country. It also assured travelers of their safety as they make their way back to their homes. The Philippine Treasury Bureau rolls out a program that aims to provide coverage for strategically important government assets. The National Insurance Indemnity Program will initially cover over 130,000 school buildings of the Education Department, with an approximate value of more than 800 billion pesos. Insured by the Government Service Insurance System, the program aims to protect government finances from unexpected losses due to disasters like typhoons and earthquakes, and ensure access to funding post-disaster for reconstruction.
The Philippine Stock Exchange sees a stronger fundraising pipeline this year after a sluggish IPO movement in 2023. Now, last year, only three companies made their PSE debut, well below the targeted 14. At the same time, the local bourse also saw seven delistings. PSE President and CEO Ramon Monzon now urging companies to not underestimate the power of the public market.
We're projecting about 4 to 5 IPOs. To raise about 40 to 50 billion. But our capital raising activity will increase the forecast to about 160 to 170 from 139. When you do an IPO, the IPO price is not the be all and end all of your IPO. It's really just the beginning. I mean, if you really believe in the, you know, the fundamentals of your company, in the, you know, good prospects of your company, the price is going to be, you're going to be rewarded with a higher price.
Meanwhile, Monzon also shared some exciting projects lined up for the local bourse, including trading on depositary receipts, algorithmic trading, and even derivatives.
Among the ASEAN exchanges, we have agreed that we will launch depository receipts in our respective markets. Meaning, why do we like that setup? Because as our local shares get traded abroad, it's going to create liquidity in our market here. Because for every share traded abroad, let's say of Telephone, the sponsor, the market maker, will have to buy one share here. So it's going to be on a 1-for-1 basis. So we're pretty excited about that. We're also started our, immersion on derivatives. We'd like to launch derivatives by 2026, hopefully fourth quarter of 2025, but maybe first quarter of 2026. Wow. We are working with the Hong Kong Stock Exchange, trying to, learn from them on how we should be doing this correctly.
A unit of Europe's largest lender closes the sale of its retail banking business in France. HSBC Continental Europe completed, for an undisclosed amount, the transaction with My Money Group of the U.S. private equity fund Cerberus. It will see the operation of HSBC France, nearly 250 branches, as well as its 800,000 clients, becoming part of MMG's unit in France. This pushes MMG's total assets beyond 30 billion euros. The undertaking, which took more than 2 years to close, is part of the British lender's efforts to refocus its operations in Asia. After seeing a double-digit increase in sales last year, Chinese car maker Geely Automobile is setting the bar higher this 2024. It aims to sell 1.9 million units this year, up from the 1.6 million sold in 2023. The company also aims to increase the sales numbers of its new energy vehicles by over 66%. Geely is China's second largest automaker by sales. Nigeria aims to raise its annual oil and condensates production output to 2.6 million barrels per day by 2026. That's an ambitious jump from 2023 levels of around 1.6 million barrels per day. Africa's biggest oil exporter has suffered a decline in production due to crude theft and vandalism of pipelines impacting government revenue. The local oil regulator said its action plan will direct development of oil assets to areas less prone to theft and vandalism. It also vowed to support the alternative crude oil education routes. The government, for its part, revealed global oil majors have committed to invest $13.5 billion in the country.